Hello and welcome. My name is Frank von Hagel. I'm one of the speakers of the Specialist Group for Documentation of the German Museum Association and working at the Institute for Museum Research. I would like to tell you something about the museum documentation in Germany, and we'll start with a short view on the landscape of German museums. As you may know, cultural work in Germany is a task of the federal states. With some exceptions, this also applies to the more than 6,500 museums in Germany. Many of the museums are run by local authorities, federal states, counties, and private individuals. More than 3,300 museums have less than 10,000 visitors in a year. That means these museums are run often by a little number of staff or by volunteers. So the professional specialization and conference participation is hardly realizable in these facilities. There is no authority in Germany that defines central legal requirements or standards for the work of museums. The museums have exclusively the possibility to seek support on a voluntary basis from regional museum association or from the working groups of the German Museum Association and ECOM. Against this background, it is clear that the professional exchange is of great importance for the work in the museums. The Deutsche Museumsbund, founded in 1917, and ECOM are the two national museum organizations in Germany. They are representing the museum's landscape. Fortunately, both organizations work well and closely together. They even have the same address, in der Halde 1 in Berlin, which is also the address of the Institute for Museum Research. As you can see, the idea of networking is lived out here in a very practical way. The museum organizations is organized in 15 working and specialist group, and one of them is the specialist group for documentation. The documentation specialist group in the German Museum Association is the counterpart of the CDOC working group. It is a group that deals with all facets of museum documentation. The association and the documentation specialist group publish handouts, best practices, and working materials. These materials are practical and application-oriented, above all to enable the colleagues to orient themselves to standards. Within this specialist group, there are various working groups for data formats, vocabularies, collection management, long-term preservation, and so on. The documentation specialist groups also work together with a number of national and international partners. And many of the members are well known here in the CDOC circle. Names like Axel Ermert, Monika Hagedorn-Saupe, Martina Krug, Regine Stein are well known and supervising working groups on their special topics. I would like to briefly mention some important contributions from the work of the working group in the last years. For example, the AG Sammlungsmanagement Working Group Collection Management. Together with the Institute for Museum Research, the working group has translated the Spectrum Standard, adapted it to the legal German conditions, and implemented very helpful workflow charts. Fortunately, they also took it upon themselves to tackle the German version of Spectrum 5.0. In the last years, Spectrum was in such high demand by museums that there are hardly any printed copies left, and the download numbers are still good. Most regional museum associations and museum offices recommended its use in the revision and planning of work processes in museums still now. Within the framework of the AG Regelwerke, Rules and Regulations, some enthusiasts have started to translate the Art and Architecture Thesaurus into the German language. In addition to the translation work with Getty, a German platform for the first step accessing to the AAT was created. Further vocabularies that are used in German museums are edited and published by members of the working group also. For this purpose, the platform museumsvokabular.de was created. Unfortunately, not all of them are equipped with services for web-based use yet, so you can also find simple PDF files. However, we are striving to provide these vocabularies with web services as well. And of course, there is also a German Lido working group in our specialist group. Together with colleagues from other institutions interested in data exchange, they are working in the possibilities of using, developing and definitions for the Lido in portals. Of course, maybe as a result of the Europeana, there is also a national portal for access to cultural heritage in Germany. The Deutsche Digitale Bibliothek, the German Digital Library, contains approximately 11 million digitized items and 35 million object information. The 213 museums form the largest group of the 544 data providing institutions. And in the ranking of the data sets supplied with digitized data, the museums are still in the third place. As is customary in Germany, some federal states have also set up their own state portals on cultural heritage. These includes, for example, Bavaricon, LeoBW, Sachsen Digital, Virtual Museum Mecklenburg-Vorpommern and Kulturerbe Niedersachsen. Another type of online platform that have emerged in Germany in the last years are the specialist portals. Their main focus is on bringing together in-depth information from a wide range of institutions in one internet resource. I would like to mention only four of them, which characterize very different approaches. Arachne for Archaeology and Classical Antiquities contains deepened data with a priority XML export, low quality images, good visualizations by a context and a hierarchy browser. But for high quality images and several services, a registration is needed. Graphikportal presents hand drawings and prints. It can be used without registration, but then without a watch list or a search storage. It contains a command and order function, detailed data. The images can be downloaded, but not the data. The Kranach Digital Archive is free accessible and offers, in addition to high quality digitized material, access to historical documentation and completed research work. Those promoting interdisciplinary research and teaching. Numit Online, coins and medals from numismatic collections can be used without registration, contains deepened data enriched with various standard data and downloadable images and metadata. There is a visualization of the sites and mines by means of a map as well. The provision of information about cultural heritage objects has become more and more important in German museums, not only for online services. Many other museum departments need the data. May it be public relations, loans, the research projects, the APP development and virtual exhibitions. So the documentary work gets into the focus. As a result, for me, we have to make our know-how, our vocabularies, our standards, our interfaces and our formats more and more open and free accessible. For example, by providing appropriated services. But we have also made clear why museum objects need these standards. A good example can be found for numismatic collections. The colleagues have created an international platform for the provision of definitions and stable URIs of numismatic concepts. All concepts are, as far as possible, not only provided with their own URI, they are also enriched with many other identifiers as possible. They are using Wikidata, GND, AAT, Freebase, and so on. This is a first step. In my point of view, it would also be important to actively introduce our vocabulary as relevant content on open platform. One example of how this could happen is the initiative GND4C. GND means the integrated authority file of the German libraries. This project wants to extend the vocabulary developed in German-speaking libraries with the vocabulary of other cultural institutions like archives, films, collections, museums, etc. Also, Wikidata appears here as an interesting project. Wikidata creates unique IDs for different concepts based on the wikis. These concepts are linked to the identifier, for example to the GND and other vocabularies. The term steam engine, for example, has 24 IDs. From the Bibliothèque Nationale de France, via GND, Art and Architecture Thesaurus, the Library of Congress, the UNESCO Thesaurus ID, etc. It works according to the well-known principle and is now a central point in the LOD cloud. The participation of museums in these developments makes it possible to increase the networking capability of the collection objects, persons, and contexts with other cultural assets. It would be possible to create new approaches to object-related research, the visualization of context, and the use of our documentation data as a basis for new research. Dear colleagues, thank you for your attention, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask now or later. Thank you.